Hello, my name is Brian and I'm in 7th grade. Today, I'll be showing you my curriculum fair project regarding how the counterweight of a trebuchet affects its launch distance. Here's the question that this experiment will be centered around. How will increasing the counterweight of a trebuchet affect its launch distance? Will the increase in counterweight cause a projectile to fly further than it does with a lighter counterweight, or will the opposite result occur? We can answer these questions by creating a controlled experiment. Before starting my experiment, I conducted research to figure out how to build an optimal trebuchet and how different counterweights would likely affect its launch distance. Trebuchets have five main parts: the frame, axle, beam, counterweight, and launcher. These pieces all work together to help the trebuchet function. Trebuchet projectiles are fired by using the energy of a dropping weight. The main factors in increasing launch distance is the fall time of the weight, the height of the frame, and the length of the beam. Because it is the fall time of the trebuchet that affects the launch distance more, there should be a cutoff point where an increase in counterweight won't have a large effect on the launch distance. Another important mechanic is the placement of the beam. If the counterweight is shifted too far forward, then there will be less velocity. However, if the counterweight is shifted too far back, the weight will not have enough room to maximize fall time. Here are the variables in this project. The independent variable is the counterweight, and the dependent variable is the launch distance of the projectile. Some constants, or controlled variables, include the testing field, the projectile itself, and the trebuchet release force. Here's my hypothesis. If the weight of the counterweight in a trebuchet is increased, then the launch distance of the projectile will increase. To build a trebuchet, we will need a handful of materials. The most important pieces are the wooden planks, which you can find at a local Home Depot store. We will also need a 40-centimeter axle, 16 nails, and some other basic building tools. Here's the first part of my building procedure. Here's the second part of my building procedure. And here's the firing procedure once the trebuchet is finished. Here's my data table. I had 7 levels and 5 replicates. The independent variable is on the left and the mean is on the right. Here's my graph. I graphed the means from the table, and as you can see, from 1 kilogram to 7 kilograms, there was a massive increase. But from 5 kilograms to 7 kilograms, there was only a very little increase. Here's my risk analysis. There are a few injuries that can occur when building the trebuchet, so be very careful. When launching the trebuchet, make sure you're in an open area so nothing gets broken. Here's my error analysis. There were 2 systematic errors that began to show up once the heavier counterweights were attached. Because the weights were attached using a box tied with a string, the 7-kilogram weights began heavily straining the string and the box. The most prominent systematic error was the overswing of the trebuchet. With heavier weights, the beam of the trebuchet swung over so fast that on occasion, the tennis ball never even flew out. In conclusion, the hypothesis that an increase in counterweight will cause an increase in launch distance is approved. From 1 kilogram to 5 kilograms, the launch distance increased by 709%. However, from 5 kilograms to 7 kilograms, the launch distance only increased by 3.6%. This shows that there is indeed a cutoff point. Further testing can be done with a larger trebuchet and heavier weights to see if the cutoff point still occurs. So, to finish up this presentation, it's only fair that we make a wah go boom. And who's going to help us do it? Meet Tiffany the tennis ball. Here's my work cited. Here's my image license. And here are my music credits.